Morning. Welcome to Knollwood United Methodist Church. We're glad that you're with us, even though we're not together in person. Please join in the call to worship. Call on the name of God and give thanks.
Make known God's deeds among the people.
Sing and tell of God's wonderful works.
Let those who seek God rejoice in their hearts.
Let us worship God.
We come to give thanks and worship the Lord.
The opening hymn is The Church's One Foundation. It's number 545 in the United Methodist Hymnal. Please join in the opening prayer. Lord, whether we have come to you from long ago or have just come to you now, you reach out with love and blessing for each one of us. O Lord, we remember the multitude of blessings you have given us. We are mindful of the ways in which you have lifted us when we have fallen low. Be with us this day as we gather to hear your word for our lives and remember your mercy and your love, that we may share these blessings with each other. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
And let us say together the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning, children of Knollwood United Methodist Church, and good morning, children everywhere. Some of you may be returning to your classes, but I think that most of you are doing your classes online, like on Zoom. Your teachers are working so hard to make this all happen. This is all new technology in many ways for them. We didn't used to do Zoom. And I know that they are working so hard. Kudos to all the teachers out there who are doing the best job they can to educate you. So you can probably name your favorite teacher. And I know you miss your teachers and you miss your buddies and you miss talking to them. And you're looking forward to being back in your classroom and doing all that. But we as Christians are so blessed because greatest teacher of all, Jesus Christ, is with us 24/7. So what does 24/7 mean? It means that 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, he is with us. We can talk to him. We can ask him questions. We can say, I'm having a hard time right now. I need some help here. And then if we listen, we're going to hear his beautiful voice. The Bible is full of his teachings. The Ten Commandments, which Pastor Kalesita talked about last week, you all know. And it includes telling us to love our neighbors as ourselves. That can be a hard one. Maybe we don't have the nicest neighbor, right? But Jesus says, love your neighbor as yourself. He told us to love our enemies. That's a hard one too, because that isn't always easy when people aren't nice. I bet that everybody listening right now has had somebody talk to them or say something to them that wasn't nice. And in that situation, it's upsetting, and you want to say something back that might not be very nice either. But that's where Jesus says, turn the other cheek. Take a deep breath. Think of something kind to say, and think about the fact that that person's probably not having a really good day, and they're just trying to get that out. So, Jesus is saying, forgive. And in Matthew 5, verse 39, he says that, and to turn the other cheek is an expression like, kind of turn away from it, let it go away, and hopefully the other person is going to see that you're not going to be nasty back, and that you do care. So, children, in other words, be kind to other children. Let us pray. Dear God, you have shown your amazing love for all children. Please help us to be strong, especially when it's hard, and to pass on love, not hurtful words, to other children. Amen.
Let us pray a travel mercy for those who are traveling. And let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we come before you, lift up all the blessings and give thanks to you as we honor, give glory to your holy name. So often we, God, we come before you with our hearts, burdens, with fear, worry, concerns. We ask for forgiveness, O God, through your Son, Jesus Christ, and may we pray and share with you what's burdened our hearts. We pray for our congregations for healing, strength, comfort. We pray for those who got affected by COVID-19, by the fires, natural disasters. We pray for our brothers and sisters in the Armenian community and the war that's going on in the world, for your peace. Oh Lord, we pray for our leaders of our community to seek you, oh God. May your godly wisdoms instill in their hearts and their minds. And we pray as we vote the right person that will be the leaders in our community, in our state, and in our nation. Oh Lord, I lift up my brother-in-law and his family. For such a time as this of losing a beloved mother who loved her children's and her husband's, but have been taken so fast. We pray for peace, comfort, and love. And we pray for those who lost their loved ones to remain faithful and be strong and be courageous. For you are with us, O God, healing, comfort, and strength. As we read the scriptures, do not worry, but present everything with supplication and prayer. And the peace of God that beyond our understanding will come and instill in our minds and our hearts. Hear our prayers, O God. With all the prayer concerns that we have in our hearts, we lift it up to you. And let us be grateful and be faithful and stand firm in our faith and trust in you, O Lord, our strength and our refuge. And we pray all this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Amen.
Scripture reading comes to us from the book, the Apostle Paul's letter to the Philippians, chapter 4, verses 1 through 9. Therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved and longed for, my joy and crown, so stand fast in the Lord, my dearly beloved. I beseech Euodias and beseech Syntyche that they may be of the same mind in the Lord. And I entreat thee also, true yoke fellow, help those women which labored with me in the gospel, with Clement also, and with other my fellow laborers, whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say, rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thank you.
Good morning. Pastor Kalesita has asked me to say a few words about our upcoming stewardship campaign at KUMC. First and foremost, the Finance Committee wants to give a huge shout out to all of you who have continued to faithfully support the finances of our church. Because of that support, our bills have been paid and our apportionments have been met. We are blessed to continue to have our secretary, Rebecca, our music director, Misty, and Pastor Kalesita working diligently every week to put together an online service for each of us. These are rough times, and the viral pandemic has changed all of our lives. As Christians, we know that the Lord is faithful and that He expects us to be faithful to His church. We humbly thank each and every one of you for all of your continued support and your caring spirit that helps other people in their time of need. Our pledge campaign is going to be a little bit different this year, but we will keep you apprised of that as it unfolds. In the past, we sent a letter to you. You will be receiving a letter again this year. May the Lord bless and keep each and every one of you safe and well. Thank you.
It's time of the year that we come together to launch our stewardship campaign, in which we invited some of you to share your faith story, how important for you to give to the church, because it's impact your spiritual life and your relationship with God and with others. Well, I thanks Lynnda Kroy that share a few words of thanks for all your faithfulness, all your giving and support. And I hope that in the next few Sundays, some of you were able to share the same words of encouragement, because your giving has not only impacted your spiritual life, but also bless our church so we can be a blessing in the community and throughout the world. Yes, we may be closed, our church, for in-person worship and any other activities happening here in our property, but we have continued since March to be in ministry through sharing the word of God in so many ways, praying, reaching out to the needy. We have been a church to share hope and bring light in the midst of darkness and during this pandemic. And now, and as I share our message this morning, I have been thinking about what we are going through. Who would ever thought we would be in a year like this? Who would ever thought we would be living in such a time of many uncertainties and stress? Who would ever thought we wouldn't be worshiping in person for 7 months because of this coronavirus? Yes, we are approaching the election season. We're still searching for the right vaccine, which people said, the scientists said, it may take a year or two to develop. And we have experienced how our economy has been affected, a lot of people, and many of them losing their job. Yes, we wonder how we can survive, how we can manage to be a church. I like what Bishop Hagia write in his briefing this past week. He says, all of us continue to try to make sense out of the current situation and the current state of the world. And there seems to be no end in sight to the bad news we are experiencing. However, Bishop says, our work and our wonder is to boldly resist denial and with equal boldness refuses despair which means that we are to resisting denial and telling the truth, refusing despair and proclaiming hope. And that's what Apostle Paul is saying to us today in Philippians 4. Paul is calling all Christians that no matter what is happening in our midst and around us, rejoice in the Lord, and again, rejoice. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests into God, and the peace of God, which transcends of all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Yes, you may ask, how can we rejoice and do not worry during this pandemic? Well, John chapter 10, verse 10, Jesus said, I come to give you life and give it to you abundantly. It is God's will for humanity to be liberated, to be free from all this worried and stress and anxiety. In Matthew 6, verse 25 to 30, hear what Jesus is preaching on the mount. I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes? Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than them? Can any one of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? Worry doesn't add you an hour, a day, a week, a month, a year to your life. Instead, worry adds to you more anxiety, stress, and according to the scientist, it will cause real emotional distress and can lead all of us to become unwell and at worst, developing anxiety disorders, such as panic attacks and obsessional behaviors. Anxiety at this level can have a truly distressing and debilitating impact on our lives, an impact on our physical well-being as well as our mental health. Yes, theologically, anxiety is a sign of a deeper reality of your spiritual life, of your faith, and what's going on inside you. A person feels so insecure and worried, believing that no one cared, and there is no God to take care of me, and most likely you denied God and God's presence. And when you believe that no one cares for you, you feel lonely and isolated, a feeling of self-denial. But Jesus tells us that we are not orphans, but children of God. We have a heavenly Father in heaven who loves us and cares for us. He wants us to trust him, and when we trust in God, either sunny days or rainy days, in bad situations, under circumstances, or on a very good day, learn to trust him always. For God is in control, and God is able to take care of you. Why? Because God created you. And he created you to love you and care for you. So we are truly loved by God. Paul also say in Romans 8, God is love and nothing will separate us from the love of God. Jesus said, even though we live in this world, we are not of this world. Romans 12, 1 and 2. But we are to renew our mind and be transformed so we'll be able to understand and recognize and have faith and know that God is with us and God loves us. We all can rise above the circumstances and become conquerors through our Lord Jesus Christ. Romans 8, 37. So from Jesus' Sermon on the Mount reminded us how God provides for all his creation. And if God takes care of the birds and the lilies of the field, which are very quiet and insignificant compared to you and I. But we must seek God first and his righteousness. Remain faithful and trust in him. And that's what Paul is saying in Philippians 4. Rejoice in the Lord and give thanks to the Lord. Seek him with prayer and supplication. And when we seek God and his righteousness, all that we need will be provided. Remember, the Spirit of God is with you and with us. He comes to be with us, to remind us that there is a God who cares for all of us. So rejoice, rejoice always. And when we, in the spirit of rejoice and gratefulness and thankfulness, we appreciate it, all that we have. We appreciate it, what God has done in our lives. As we have shared with one another since this pandemic, yes, we may be lonely in our own home, but God has been taking care of us. None of us got affected by COVID-19. And we have seen how many people who have passed away from this virus. But thanks be to God. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, good or bad, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, presented your request to the Lord. It's true, when you pray, you are bringing your burdens and your problems to the one you are praying to, because you know that God hears your prayers. I always enjoy when we get together on Thursday evening for our Bible study and prayer. Yes, we do believe in the power of prayer. And when we gather and study the word of God, and we lead us into sharing our prayer concerns, and together we lift our voice to the Lord, for God hears our prayers. Church, I encourage you to have a prayer life, especially for such a time as this. Right now, this is the time that we need to pray most. Paul is telling us to pray and don't worry. From his own personal experience, he's in Roman prison right at the moment. He was writing these words of encouragement, telling the people, the Christians in Philippi, to rejoice in the Lord, for the Lord is near. God is with you. God is with me, even though I am in the darkness of the prison. But I know God will take care of me. And you know he's waiting for his persecution. He didn't know what's come tomorrow. But he is at peace. When you pray and lift up all your burdens, your problems, and share with the Lord, God will give you that peace that transcends our understanding and will guard our minds and our hearts. It is very important to guard our minds from things that are happening around us, so we know and affirm the presence of God in our midst. My brother-in-law called me 2 days ago, telling me that his wife just passed away, leaving him with 6 little children, much younger than my children. And he said, I don't know what to do. I am totally lost. What can I do? The same question that we ask ourselves when we face hardship and suffering in trouble. We are worried and we ask, what can we do? Let me remind you, the Holy Spirit is our comforter to strengthen us, to help us, to sustain us in the midst of death and loss. So I pray with him and encourage him to be strong for his children. And I share my experience. I have been through the same situation 5 years ago when I lost my husband. It's all with prayers, the support from each other, and be strong in my faith and trust that God will take care of us. And here I'm sharing with you as we pray and be strong, for God is with him. And I always like this hymn that we used to sing. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. O soul, are you weary and troubled? No light in the darkness you see. There is light for a look at the Savior and life more abundant and free. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Yes, Paul say, turn your eyes upon Jesus and present your request to God. And when we pray, we believe that God is all listening. He is a loving heavenly Father, just like a father here on earth, that listening to his child and provided for his or her needs. The promise to those who rejoice and pray and present everything to the Lord with your faith and trust, the peace of God will transcend your understanding, will guard you, your heart and your mind. The peace of Jesus Christ is very powerful because he is the Prince of Peace. His peace is not of this world, but that which comes down from above, so that peace will come and protect you from evil. You guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. It is imperative that our hearts is steadfast and keep faith and trust in the Lord. Likewise, our mind must be set and focused on the Lord. Paul tells us the spirit of fear works against our mind, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1, verse 7. God comes to give us boldness and sound mind. A warrior must have clarity of mind and boldness of heart in order to be effective in fighting with his enemy. This is also like the warrior being fully equipped with the helmet of salvation, breastplate of righteousness, and the rest of armor. As we pray and bring our needs to the Lord, he will cause his peace, which transcend all understanding, to protect you in the name of Jesus Christ. Church, we may not be in church, but we continue to serve the Lord in wherever we are. With your prayers, we'll bring hope to those who are stressed and anxiety. God will take care of our church. God will take care of us. But God wants you to take part in faithfully giving and sharing and supporting each other. For God loves the faithful giver. One of my favorite hymns, God Will Take Care of You, was written by Sevilla Martin after being inspired by her son, who trust in the care of God will provide. Sevilla Martin and her husband, Reverend W. Stillman Martin, was invited to preach at a church. And on that Sunday morning, Mrs. Martin became suddenly ill, making it possible for her to accompany her husband to his preaching assignment. Mr. Martin seriously considered canceling his preaching, since it would be needful for him to be gone from her for considerable time. Just then, however, their young son spoke up and said, Father, don't you think that if God wants you to preach today, he will take care of mother while you are away? Friends and family, God will take care of us. God will take care of you. God is in the midst of all this. As God took care of Paul in prisons, and he died for good cause, so you and I can witness in his letters of his faith, and we can do all things in God who strengthens us. Yes, God will take care of our church, but God needs you to be faithful in your giving, in your sharing. For God created this world. God created you and I, and bless us with the responsibility to take care of his world. We have made a promise to be a member of this congregation in service, in ministry, in sharing, in preaching, in teaching. What is that you need to present to the Lord? Turn your eyes upon God. During this pandemic, during this election season, time of hatred, wildfires that destroys many homes, there's wars going on. Paul reminded us that nothing will separate us from the love of God. God will take care of you and God will take care of all of us. We just need to rejoice, for God is near. Do not be anxious, but present everything in prayer and thanksgiving to God in Christ Jesus. God will give you his peace. Amen. Bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, the peace that surpasses all understanding. Be with you and your family in such a time as this. Know that God is near you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our son, Otto, and nice, right?